Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to install a cellular communicator to your 2GIG Go control panel. This 2GIG Go control, as you may have seen with some of our other 2GIG installation and programming videos, is an all-in-one wireless system for security and Z-Wave home automation. The security sensors are wireless RF sensors. They work just with the panel. The panel is Z-Wave ready out of the box. However, to really use Z-Wave, you need a cellular communicator in the panel active with some sort of service. And there are a few different options for the communications to put into this panel. So we're going to review those options, and then we're going to show you how to install the one that we found had the best service for our installation at this property. So the panel, the 2GIG panel, will work with alarm.com cellular communicators, and it will work with Telguard cellular communicators. For alarm.com, you have four different communicators. There is the GCC-DMV-A. That is a Verizon CDMA communicator. There is an AT&T GC3-GA-A, which is an alarm.com AT&T cellular communicator. And then for those of you in Canada, it would be a GC3-GR-A. If you notice, the last number there or digit is R, and for Rogers, which is the cellular network in Canada. So if you were in Canada, that would be the one to get, and that's really your only option in Canada. And then finally, if you're in Mexico, on the Movistar network, there is a 2GMV52-A. Those are the four alarm.com options to add a cellular communicator for alarm.com monitoring service or Z-Wave automation service. Finally, if you wanted to do Telguard, which is the other option, it's AT&T only, and it's a GC3GA-T. So the dash, the letter at the end of the part number will tell you A is alarm.com, T for Telguard. We checked our cell coverage at this installation location, and we found that the CDMA Verizon unit was the best option. And so therefore, we're going to be installing our GCC-DMV-A communicator inside of our 2GIG Go control. Now that we've decided which cellular communicator to install, we're going to show you how it installs. The first thing you want to do is power down your 2GIG Go control. You never want to install a cellular module with the panel powered on. So at the top of our panel, we have a small screw that holds the control panel to the back plate. We remove that and set that aside. And then with a flathead screwdriver, there are two tabs at the top, one on the left, one on the right. If you have a decent sized flathead, you just insert it into the notch and twist, and the panel pops open. You can see console tamper alerting you to the panel tamper was triggered. We make sure with our third arm that we latch it here so that the panel doesn't fall down. And to remove power, we're disconnecting both the backup battery, and we're using a barrel plug for our DC power, so we're going to unplug that as well. So the battery, you want to kind of hold down the clip on the board and then pull out from the board to disconnect. Now our backup battery is removed, and finally for our DC power coming from our wall outlet, we simply disconnect there. You want to make sure everything's powered down. You can see no lights on the screen, buttons don't do anything. So now with power removed, we can install our module. Now that we have our panel opened up and powered down, we're ready to install our 2GIG-GCC-DMV-A alarm.com CDMA or Verizon cellular alarm communicator. The right-hand corner of our 2GIG Go control panel has a nice open space. We have two screw holders here, and we have a pin connector at the bottom. On the back side of our communicator, we have the male pins. So we simply line up the pins. And put a little pressure to push it towards the board. You can see the screw holes line up perfectly there, and the unit comes with two screws and washers, which we want to use to secure the cellular communicator to the 2GIG GO control. So one at a time, we're going to screw in our two screws. Just so that this unit won't ever become loose inside the panel. One screw down. Get our second screw. Twist into place, and we now have our Verizon communicator installed in the unit. Now that we have our Verizon communicator secured to our 2GIG GO control, the next step of the installation is to install our 2GIG ANT3X external antenna. This is a paddle switch antenna, and it secures to the board with this little connector here. This is a delicate connector, so just be careful. Don't go at an angle or anything. It's much more important that when removing it, you remove it properly for damaging it. It's less, it's more difficult to damage it to push it in, because as long as you're straight and you push it in, you should be good. Certainly don't want to put it in here yet, though, because then you got to, you wouldn't be able to install the antenna where you need it. So there's a couple places where you can install the antenna. If you notice on the back plate, it says external antenna right here, and this little plastic, if you cut these four knockouts, it will pop out and you'd have an actual hole where you could fit your antenna in the wall and drop it down behind the panel, or install it up in the wall above the panel so that you would get your maximum reception. That would be a really tough installation where you had really poor cell coverage and you need to have this in an exact spot. Because we've already spent the time to figure out that Verizon has really good cell coverage here, we're going to be fine to install the antenna right in the panel. There's actually a connector, or rather an open spot in the plastic where there's this little tab that you just, with your finger, pull out. It's just a little plastic cover. And you have this nice little slot here, which is perfect for the antenna. So you install it vertically there. You route your antenna connector cable, connector end through this hole, fit the antenna in place. You want to run your cable along the bottom, and then again it's just a simple plug push until it snaps, and our antenna cable and antenna is now properly installed to give adequate cell coverage to this location. So final step, power up the panel. As always, with the power up on this panel, we want to do battery first. So we do our battery connection, plug it into place until it snaps. We're using a barrel plug for our power from our wall outlet, as opposed to screwing to our terminals. So it's as simple as connecting to the barrel plug input. And now we're ready to close up the panel. We can reinstall our plastic cover so that our antenna doesn't fall out. And we have our
system ready to arm.
We can hear the panels in the process of booting while we're making our last connections here. And then we have our case cover screw at the top that we install. By just screwing it down to secure the control panel to the back plate. So now we're back on the wall. You can see it came up to a powered on sequence, and we have this flashing message here with the envelope. If we tap that, you can see your security website login info. So because these modules do not work without a service provider, we've already had to have activated this communicator through an alarm company. So of course, Alarm Grid offers that service. If you're with another company, they would have had to register that module with alarm.com's website in advance of your installation there. And once you set up the account, it actually will send you your login credentials for alarm.com right to the panel. You also get an email as well, but it's kind of handy that it comes right to the panel. It is secure. You would have to actually enter your master code to view that information. But we now have an alarm.com capable system, and our 2GIG Go Control can now be monitored, offer alarm.com service, and more importantly perhaps is be able to do the Z-Wave home automation with lights, locks, and thermostats. Now that our Verizon CDMA communicator is installed in our 2GIG panel, the last step of the installation is to ensure we have adequate cell coverage. This is going to verify we've installed our communicator properly, that our antenna is connected properly, and that this installation location is going to have adequate cell coverage for our alarm monitoring services and our alarm.com services. So, there are two ways to run a cell test from the panel. One way is to hit the Go Control icon in the bottom right corner. In this case, they're looking for your installer code. Out of the box, or by default, 1561 gets you to here. And if you hit radio status and cell phone test, you have some information about the radio showing it's registered and things like that. And if you run a cell phone test, it'll go through a sequence to give you your actual signal strength. The other way to do it would be to do security, menu, toolbox, and your master code. Now from here, you can do the right arrow twice until you get to cell phone test. And again, they want the master code, 1111 out of the box. And now you see that it's running the cell phone test. Takes a couple minutes. You just kind of wait for the results. Looks like it worked very quickly to indicate we have real good cell coverage. Cell phone test successful. Completed successfully. The cell phone is working correctly.
System disarmed.
So you notice when we did the master code there, it gave us a very basic message that yes, it worked. If it didn't work, call your provider. You know, contact your service company. So if you were to have done it from the original way with the 1561 by hitting Go Control and then installer code, this radio status gives you a little bit more information. So as an installer, you have the more detailed information here.
System disarmed.
On the screen, you can see we have a signal strength of 16 out of 31, which is going to be sufficient signal strength for our installation. So the master code will tell you, yes, it worked. By going to the installer code, you get this deeper level information about how well it worked. Either way, we know we are good, and our Verizon communicator will work for us at this location. We hope you've enjoyed this installation of the Verizon GCC-DMV-A CDMA alarm.com communicator. We invite you to subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions about installing a cell communicator into your 2GIG Go Control, please email support@alarmgrid.com.